वैदिकप्रार्थनया स्वागतं कृतवन्तः सर्वेषां धन्यवादः. कार्यदर्शी केजी राघवन् महोदयं प्रति कार्यक्रमस्य अग्रिमः भागः नियन्त्रणं कर्तुं प्रार्थये.
गुड् मार्निङ्ग् लेडीस् एण्ड् जेण्टल्मेन्. इन् मेमरी एण्ड् एस् रेस्पेक्ट् टु दि फार्मर् गवर्नर् आफ् दि स्टेट् डाक्टर् खुर्शीद् आलम् खान्, ऐ रिक्वेस्ट् आल् आफ् यू टु रैस् फार् ए मिनिट् silence. Thank you very much. Honorable Governor of Karnataka, Sri Hansraj Bharadwajji, distinguished guests on the dais, respected invitees, scholars, Bhavanites, ladies and gentlemen. In the Platinum Jubilee year of the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan and in the 125th birth year of its founder, Dr. K. M. Munshi, yet again it gives me great pleasure to be before you and consider it an unique privilege and honor to guide this inaugural session of the National Conference on Vedic Literature, a 8-day unique program organized by the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Bangalore and ISKCON. I now request the inauguration, a Vedic prayer by Veda Brahma Sri Bennagade Narasimha Bhatta Ganapati and Associates.
Om ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುಭ್ಯೋ ನಮಃ ಹರಿಃ ಓಂ ಗಣಾನಾಂತ್ವಾ ಗಣಪತಿಗುಂ ಹವಾಮಹೇ ಕವಿಂ ಕವೀನಾಮುಪಮಶ್ರವತ್ತಮಂ ಜ್ಯೇಷ್ಠರಾಜಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಣಾಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಣಃಪತ ಆನಶೃಣ್ವನ್ನೋತಿಭಿಃ ಸೇದಸಾದನಂ ಸ ಇಜ್ಜನೇನ ಸ ವಿಷಾ ಸ ಜನ್ಮನಾ ಸ ಪುತ್ರೈರ್ವಾಜಂ ಭರತೆ ಧನಾನೃಭಿಃ ದೇವಾನಾಂ ಯಃ ಪಿತರಮಾವಿವಾದತೆ ಶ್ರದ್ಧಾ ಕದಾಹ ವಿಷಾ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಣಃಪತಿಂ ಪ್ರಣೋ ದೇವೀ ಸರಸ್ವತೀ ವಾಜೇಭಿರ್ವಾಜಿನೀವತಿ ಿಯವತು ಆ ನೋ ದಿವೋ ಬೃಹತ ಪರ್ವತ ಸರಸ್ವತೀ ಯಜತ ಜಂತು ಯಜ್ಞ ಹವನ್ ದೇವೇ ಜುಜುಷಾಘೃತಿ ಷಡ್ಭಾನ್ೋ ವಾಚ ಮುಷತೆ ದೃಢೋತು ಪಿತ್ರೇ ವಿಶ್ವದೇವಾಯ ವೃಷ್ಟೇ ಯಜ್ಞೈರ್ವಿಧೇಮಸಾಹವಿರ್ಭಿಃ ಬೃಹಸ್ಪತೇ ಸುಪ್ರಜಾ ವೀರವಂತೋ ಭಯಜ್ಞಸ್ಯ ಭಪತಯೋ ರಜೇನಾಂ ಅಗ್ನೇನ ಯಸುಪಥಾ ರಾಜೇ ಅಸ್ಮಾನ್ ವಿಶ್ವಾನಿ ದೇವ ಭಜನಾನಿ ವಿದ್ವಾನ್ ಯುಜೋಧ್ಯಸ್ಮಜ್ಜುಹುರಾಣಮೇನಃ ಭೋಜಿಷ್ಠಾನ್ ದೇ ನಮ ಉಕ್ತಿಂ ವಿಧೇಮ ಪ್ರವಶುಕ್ರಾಯ ಭಾನವೇ ಬಲಧ್ವಂ ಹವ್ಯಂ ಮತಿಂ ಚಾಗ್ನಯೇ ಸುಪೋತಂ ಯೋಧೈವ್ಯಾನುಷಾ ಜನೋಗುಂಭಿ ಅಂತರ್ವಿಶ್ವಾನಿ ವಿದ್ವನಾ ಜಿಗಾತಿ ಅಚ್ಛಾ ಗಿರೋ ಭತಯೋ ದೇವಜಂದೀ ಅಗ್ನೈಯಂ ದ್ರವಿಣಂ ವಿಕ್ಷಮಾಣಾಃ ಸುಸಂರಷಕಂ ಸುಪ್ರತೀಕಜ್ಞಸ್ವಂಜಂ ಹವ್ಯವಾಹಮರತಿಂ ಮಾನುಷಾಧಾಂ ಅಗ್ನೇ ತ್ವಮಸ್ಮದ್ಯುಜೋಧ್ಯಮೀವಾಹ ಅನಗ್ನಿತ್ರಾ ಅಭ್ಯಮಂತಕೃಷ್ಟೀ ಪುನರಸ್ಮಭ್ಯಗಂ ಸುಭಿತಾಯ ದೇವ ಕ್ಷಾಂ ವಿಶ್ವೇಭಿರಜದೇಭಿರ್ಯಜತ್ರ ಅಗ್ನೇ ತ್ವಂ ಪಾದಯಾನವ್ಯೋ ಅಸ್ಮಾನ್ ಸ್ವಸ್ತಿಭಿರತಿ ದುರ್ಗಾನಿ ವಿಶ್ವಾ ಓಷ್ಟಬುತ್ಸೇ ಬಹುಲಾನ ಉರ್ವೀ ಭವತೋಕಾಯತನಯಾಯ ಶಂಯೋ ಪ್ರಕಾರವೋ ಮದನಾ ವಚ್ಯಮಾನಾಃ ದೇವದ್ರೀತೀನ್ನಯಥ ದೇವಯಂತಃ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾವಾದ್ವಾದಿನಿ ಪ್ರಾಚ್ಯೇತಿ ಹರಿರ್ಭರಂ ಜಗ್ನಜೆ ಘೃತಾತಿ ಮಮಾಗ್ನೇ ವಚ್ಚೋ ವಿಹವೇ ಸ್ವತ್ತು ಭಜಂತೇಂಧಾನಸ್ತನುಪಂ ಪುಷೇಮ ಮಹ್ಯನ್ನ ಮಂದ್ರಾಂ ಪ್ರತಿಶಸ್ತತಸ್ತ್ರಸ್ತಯಾಧ್ಯಕ್ಷೇಣ ಮೃತನಾಜಯೇಮ ಮಮ ದೇವಾ ವಿಹವೇ ಸಂತು ಸರ್ವ ಇಂದ್ರಾವಂತೋ ಮರುತೋ ವಿಷ್ಣುರಗ್ನಿಃ ಮಮಾಂತರಿಕ್ಷ ಮುರುಗೋಪಮತ್ತು ಮಹ್ಯಂ ವಾತಃ ಪ್ರವತಾಂ ಕಾಮೇ ಅಸ್ಮಿನ್ ಮಯಿ ದೇವಾದ್ರವಿಡಮಾಯದಂತಾ ಮಯ್ಯಾಶೀರಸ್ತು ಮಯಿ ದೇವಹೂತಿಃ Nikame, Nikame, no, no, Nikame, 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 Na parjanya, Varasato Palinya, Palinya, Varasato, Varasato, Palinya, Dana, Palinya, Varasato, Varasato, Palinya, Daha, Palinya, Dana, Palinya, Palinya, Dao, Sata, Dao, Sata, Dana, Palinya, Palinya, Dao, Sata, Daha, Na O Sataja O Satajo No Na O Sataja Pachyantam Pachyantam O Satajo No Na O Sataja Pachyantam O Sataja Pachyantam Pachyantam O Sataja O Sataja Pachyantam Yodakshema Yodakshema Pachyantam O Sataja O Sataja Pachyantam Yodakshema Pachyantam Yodakshema Yodakshema Pachyantam Pachyantam Yodakshema No No Yodakshema Kheva Pachyantam Pachyantam Yoga Kheva Naha Yoga Kheva Naha Yoga Kheva Yoga Kheva Nakkalpadan Kalpadan Na Yoga Kheva Yoga Kheva Nakkalpadan Yoga Kheva Iti Yoga Kheva Nakkalpatam, kalpatam, no nakkalpatam, kalpatam iti kalpatam. Om Shanti 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 Hare Om.
This conference on Vedic literature, titled Veda Samvada, has been conceived in particular with two objectives, namely, one, promoting knowledge or education amongst all stakeholders towards achieving the ultimate goal of our existence, namely, universal peace or shanti, spreading awareness as to the cosmopolitan character of the Vedas and their teaching or exhortation and their relevance to the modern times. Within this ocean of knowledge, it is our intention at this conference to ignite and promote a healthy debate towards achieving the aforesaid two objectives. There cannot be a better forum to do so. Two great organizations, namely Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan and International Society for Krishna Consciousness, ISKCON, inspired by their visionary founders, Dr. K. M. Munshiji and Sri Srila Prabhupada, coming together under one banner, scholars over 100 in number, disseminating knowledge on the immortal and eternal truths enshrined in the Vedic literature. Samsara Vishavrukshasya Dvepale Amritopame Kavyamrita Rasa Swadaha Sangatis Sujane Jane. This poison tree of samsara bears two fruits of nectar, fruit having the eternal nectar of knowledge and fruit comprising of the company of good people. We have both here, Jnana and Sajjana. They are our honored guests. True to the exhortation in the Taittiriya Upanishad, Atithi Devo Bhava, we warmly welcome them. I now request Sri N. Ramanuja, Chairman, Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Bangalore Kendra, to deliver the welcome address.
to welcome all of you to this unique national conference on Vedic literature, Veda Samvada. I welcome His Excellency Dr. H. Bharadwaj, the Honorable Governor of Karnataka, who will inaugurate this Vedic conference and give movement to the program. It may not be out of context at this juncture if I say that His Excellency has guided Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan in all its activities and also participated in all its important programs. I heartily welcome you, sir, on behalf of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, ISKCON Bengaluru, on behalf of the Vedic scholars, invitees who have assembled here, and on my own behalf. Sanmani Rajyapalarada Dr. H.R. Bharadwaj avaru Bharatiya Vidya Bhavanada ella mukhya karyakramagaligu margadarshana maduta hagu swataha namma karyakramagalalli palgolluttiddare adakkagi Bharatiya Vidya Bhavanada paravagi nimmellara paravagi avarige hrutpurkavada swagatavannu koruttene. I welcome Shatavadani Dr. R. Ganesh, under whose leadership the 8-day programs have been planned. Professor V. Kannan, ex-Vice Chancellor, University of Hyderabad, has accepted our invitation and come all the way from Hyderabad to deliver keynote address. I extend hearty welcome to you, sir. I welcome Sri Madhupandita Dasa, President ISKCON Bengaluru, who is the guest of honor and also addressing the gathering. I extend warm welcome to all the Vedic scholars who have been associated with Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan in planning this program. I welcome all the invitees, the guests and the participants who have assembled here. I assure you that all of you will be enjoying the 8-day program, which is going to enrich our knowledge in various aspects of our ancient scriptures. Samani va akutihi, samanai hridayani vaha, samanamastavo manoyata vasu sohati. Namma uddesha vandeya agirali, namma hridayada bayake vandeya agirali, nammalli purnavada oggottu iruvante namma alochanegalella vandeya agirali. Rigvedinda dhanyavadagalu.
It's now time for us to formally inaugurate this conference. I now request Dr. H.R. Bharadwaj, Governor of Karnataka, to inaugurate the conference by unveiling the original manuscripts of the Vedas kept there.
Shri Te Vate Punan Dive Jaha Kshay Bhavai
Satyajito Bhagaha Shema Deva Varunhe
At this conference, we have assembled over 100 scholars from all over the country. Over 100 topics from Vedic literature will be discussed and debated. It is Samvada. This conference will bear true testimony to the Subhashita, Vidya Vivadhaya Dhanammadaya, Shakti Paresham Paripidanaya, Kalasya Sadoho Viparita Metat, Jnanaya Dhanaya Charakshanaya. The bad use learning for quarrelsome debate, money to display arrogance, physical strength to always cause trouble to others, whereas the good use learning to spread knowledge, money for charity, and physical strength for protecting others. This is a gathering of the good, and undoubtedly, Veda Samvada will be to spread knowledge and is an earnest attempt to fuse the present with the past for eternal prosperity. The cosmopolitan character of the subjects chosen for the debate and their current relevance bear testimony to this attempt. It is pertinent at this juncture to remind ourselves of the words of wisdom of the famous Kannada literator Dr. D.V. Gundappa, DVG as he was popularly referred to in his magnum opus Mankutimman Gagga. Hosa Chigaru, Hale Beru, Kudiralu Mara Sobagu, Hosa Yukti, Hale Tattva, Odagude Dharma, Rushi Vakya Dodane, Vignanakala Melivise, Jasavu Jana Jeevanake Mankutima. A tree is most healthy and beautiful when it has old roots and fresh sprouts. Just like that, it is Dharma only when new wisdom is in harmony with ancient philosophy. When the words of sages are reverberated in acts of science and art, there is bound to be prosperity for all. I now request Dr. Shatavadani, Dr. S. R. Ganesh, a scholar in his own right, to deliver the redress on the highlights of this conference, Veda Samvada.
Atra Mahadidam Pramodasthanam Yat Sarve Janaha Abharatam Vidyamanaha Vidvamsaha Vidushyascha Samagataha Sarve Sarvascha Baddhadharaha Vedavangmaye Tebhya Bharati Vijnana Bharati Vidya Bhavanataha Tathacha Iskan Samsthaparataha Hardam Swagatam Vyahritya Samprati Asya Sanskrita Bhashayaha Madhuryam Shravitumeva Kanchan Vakyani Prastuya Samprati Anglaya Vandya Kinchet Prastuta Kamosmi Veda Samvadasya Vishaye. Veda Samvada is a very unique concept. We know there is so much of wealth, both in terms of material and spiritual, in the Vedas. But it is very rare to find a confluence of scholars coming from variegated fields and they sitting together and exchanging their thoughts, however divergent they may be, but at last we will be having some or the other convergency in our hearts. And at the same time, we wanted to see that the variety which is presented both in terms of recitation and even in the terms of interpreting the Vedas from various angles of different systems of philosophy all has to be brought out. Apart from that, what the Veda means to a common man, what the Veda means to a distinguished personality in the society, and what the Veda means to people coming from various quarters of rational and devotional learning. To all these things, we have to accommodate. Unfortunately, in Karnataka, we have good tradition. But at the same time, we didn't had such a illustrious conference earlier. In my knowledge, if Professor K.S. Kannan and other eminent people permit me to say so, this is first of its kind in the history of Karnataka. To have such a big canvas of Vedic learning coming at one point for 8 days long, from morning till evening, many sessions will go on, where various scholars coming from various parts of the country and having initiated in various aspects of Veda. Some people are well versed in the traditional knowledge of Veda, like the Shrauta Prakriya, the ritual aspect of the Veda. And some people are in Vedartha Nirnaya, etymology, and also elucidating the lofty meanings of the Veda. And some people are interested in culling out the material beauty of the Veda. For example, do we have science? Do we have Ayurveda? Do we have Rajaniti or polity? If so, how? If not, why? All these things are very much interesting to some of the scholars. And some people coming from different aspects of the regional languages. For example, many people have a blind concept that Vedas are just restricted to Sanskrit. And even they go to the extent of saying that Vedic Sanskrit is different from the classical Sanskrit and they are worlds apart. It is not so. It is the natural extension of the Vedic Sanskrit that has happened in the Paninian grammar. And even the same Vedic message is propagated by through various languages by very eminent saints, scholars and poets all over the country. That's why in Tamil Nadu, we have the Nayanmars and the Alvars. In the Karnataka, we have the Shivasharanas and the Haridasas. And in the Maharashtra, we have the Varakari Sampradaya. In the Bengal, we have the Vaishnava Bhakti and then the Shaktaya Bhakti cult, which is very well developed. So also in the North India, we have the cult of Rama and the Ramopasana, both in forms of Saguna and Nirguna as propounded by Ramananda Swamiji as well as Kapir. Like that, we have very many things which are well preserved in the tradition of India in different languages. That's why the Vedic spirit is vibrant and still living, and it is eternal in that sense. We have to consolidate all these things. That's why Veda should not be restricted just to the form itself. That's why in our tradition, we have several Panchama Vedas. Mahabharata is a Pancham Veda, Natyashastra is a Pancham Veda, Ayurveda is a Pancham Veda, Arthaveda is a Pancham Veda. Means fifth position has n number of places. N can tend to infinity. Like that we have in our tradition so many things added to the corpus of Veda with a very great mind. That's why we have the six limbs, Shiksha, Vyakarana, Chandas, Nirukta, Jyotisha and Kalpa, and also the 14 Vidyasthanas, which include Itihasa, Dharma Shastra, Purana, Nyaya Vistara. And also we have the concept of 18 Vidyasthanas, where the Upavedas are also included, Arthaveda, Ayurveda, Gandharva Veda, and Sthapatya Veda. Sometimes it is Dhanurveda as well. So in all these aspects, we have lot of bearing with respect to the formal terminology of Chaturveda. And again, we have very many interesting features connected with the structure and substance of the Veda. The structure including the semantics, phonetics and stylistics, and substance including the message of the Vedas. Message is manifolded. We have very many people coming from various walks of life. People are different, mindsets are different, thoughts are different, languages are different, ideologies are different. How the plurality is integrated in the conceptual oneness of the Vedas, all these things will be discussed. And I'm very happy that two great scholars especially, they have worked day and night in materializing this wonderful vision. And one is Professor P. Ramanujan, and other is Professor Dr. K. S. Kannan. Ramanujan is an eminent scholar of his own right in the traditional knowledge as well as in the application of Veda and propagation of Veda through the modern means of communication, electronic media and digital media. And Professor K. S. Kannan is now associated with the Sanskrit University of Karnataka, where he is heading the faculty wing of research and projects. And he is a very unique person having multifarious understanding and knowledge of not only of the Vedas, but also of the Indian culture in general, and especially arts and literature in particular. And these two people have taken a lot of pains along with the faculty of the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, headed ably by Shri H.N. Suresh and other people, and well guided by people like Shri Raghavan, whom you have seen now in his wonderful comparing how enthusiastic he is about the seminar. And of course, we have always the encouraging spirit of Shri Ramanuja, who is the chairman of the institution. And of course, many scholars are also invited. Here we have Shri Satyavrata, and then Dr. S.R. Leela, and Professor M.K. Sridhar, and such other people also invariably associated with enthusiasm. They come willingly to formulate the concept and also materialize the session. It's very difficult to call all the scholars at one time. Many scholars came, but at the same time we could not accommodate. Earlier we had lot of time, but few people turned out, and at the fag end of the organizational session we had calls from very many scholars, and they wanted to participate, and we are much beholden to their eagerness and enthusiasm and participatory spirit, but we could not accommodate all the sessions. And we know it's so difficult to accommodate all the sessions, all the scholars, and all the thoughts within the 8 days. They have considerable time. 8 days is not a small period. However, we have very much of difficulty in streamlining the sessions, because still Vedas are to be exhausted. 4 Vedas, how much? In the Yajurveda Brahmana, we have one beautiful story. Bharadvaja, having his lifespan for 300 years, he learnt Vedas.